the diversity in living things and their classification. In that classification of plants, we can easily notice the differences in the shape and height of the plants in our surroundings. It is easy to classify the plants in the basis of this observation. Now, you observe this picture. Here, different plants have different height and a different shape of their leaves. And this is very easy to classify of this observation of their height and a shape. What are the similarities between mango, a banyan, and a tremon tree? The height, all trees are heighted. Now first, trees. Some plants grow tall. Their stem or trunk is hard and strong. They have branches at some height above the ground. They bear flowers and fruits for many years. Such plants are called trees. That is, are tall, big, and perennial. That is, they live for many years. Now see, trees are very tall and their branches are at some height above the ground, and they live for many years. That's why they are called as perennials. The meaning of perennial means living for many years. Now see, the branches of this tree are some height above the ground, and tree lives for many years. That's why they called as a perennial. What are the similarities between the hibiscus, oleander, and a lantana plant? The height of all these plants are shorter than the trees. Shrubs. Some plants grow close to the ground. They leave out branches very close to the ground. They are shorter and smaller than tree, but they have thick and hard stem. The oleander, hibiscus, lantana, coranti, and rose are shrubs that they grow up to 2 to 3 meters. Now see, this is a shrub, and the branches of shrubs are very close to the ground. Now see, these branches are very close to the ground, and as compared to next, what are the similarities between a fenugreek and periwinkle plants? Both the plants have a green color stem, or their stem is very flexible. This is the similarity. Herbs. Herbs grow 1 to 1.5 meter tall. The stem of herbs are green and quick flexible as compared to those of trees and bushes. Means, as compared to tree and bushes, the stem of herbs are green and very flexible. Herbs may live for a few months or up to 2 years. Means, the lifespan of herbs is few months or 2 years. According to the size and height of the stem, plants can be classified into three types. Now here we saw the three types: first trees, second shrubs, and herbs. Now how we are classify these according to their size and their stem? Vines. Some vines need vertical support for growing, while some others spread on the ground. Now see here, some vines are taking support of a vertical, means stick. They are taking a support of stick, and some vines are spread on a ground. See, this watermelon vine is spread on a ground. Climbers like the money plant have aerial roots. Have you seen the cucumber trundles that look like a spring? Of what use could they be? Does the stem and stem of any vines, what do you feel? Now see, this is a spring-like structure is there. See, this spring-like structure is called as a aerial roots. Aerial roots, and the use of aerial roots is supporting the vines. Touch the stem of any vines, what do you feel? The stem is very soft and flexible. The stem of vines is very soft and flexible. The stem of a creeper is a very flexible, soft and green. It grows rapidly with the help of a support. For how many years do you crops like bajra, wheat, corn, radish, marigold live? The life cycle of plants like jawar, sunflower is completed in 1 year. These plants are called as annuals, means the lifespan is only for 1 year. That's why it is called as annual. The life cycle of the plants like the carrot, beetroot is for 2 years. Life cycle of plants like carrot and beetroot is for 2 years. They are called biennial. They are called as biennials. Shrubs like the hibiscus and oleander and trees like mango and gulmohar live for several years and bear flowers and fruits. They are called as perennials. Means many trees, mango, gulmohar, hibiscus, they live for many years. For that's why they are called as perennials. According to the period of their life cycle, plants are classified as annual, biennial and perennial. Annual means they live for only 1 year. Which example is given here? Jawar and sunflower. Biennial means they live for 2 years. Example, carrot and beetroot. Perennial means live for many years. Example, mango, gulmohar and hibiscus. To which part of plants are butterfly and insects attracts? Which plant? Obviously, flower. Which plant? Flower. Plants that bear flowers is called as a flowering plants. Means which plants gives flower, that plant is called as a flowering plants. While the plants that never bear flowers are called as non-flowering plants. Which plants are not giving flowers is called as a non-flowering plants. Non-flowering plants may not have organs like root, stem and leaves. Non-flowering plants do not have organs like root, stem and leaves. Flowering plants is called as those plants giving flower, that is called as a flowering plants, and the plants which are not giving flower is called as a non-flowering plants. Where does the pomegranate shrubs grow? Where does pomegranate shrubs grow? On land. Where does the lotus grow? Where does the lotus grow? इन वॉटर. वेयर डज ब्लूशर्स एंड रेलरोड्स क्रेपर्स ग्रो? वेयर डज द ड्रोडेरा प्लांट ग्रो? वी सी डिफरेंट प्लांट ग्रो इन अ डिफरेंट प्लेसेस अराउंड अस. प्लांट्स कैन बी क्लासिफाइड अकॉर्डिंग टू देयर हैबिटेट्स और द प्लेस वेयर दे ग्रो. मीन्स सम प्लांट्स आर ग्रोइंग इन वॉटर, सम प्लांट्स आर ग्रोइंग इन अ ऑन अ लैंड. लैंड वॉटर मर्शी एरिया डेजर्ट एंड इवन अ बिग ट्री आर द वेरियस हैबिटेट्स ऑफ प्लांट्स. नाउ सी वॉट एवर एग्जाम क्वेश्चंस आर गिवन बिलो, इन दैट सम प्लांट्स आर लिविंग ऑन लैंड, सॉरी सम प्लांट्स आर ग्रोइंग इन लैंड, सम प्लांट्स आर ग्रोइंग इन वॉटर मीन्स एक्वेटिक प्लांट्स, सम प्लांट्स आर ग्रोइंग इन मर्शी एरियाज डेजर्ट एंड इवन अ बिग ट्री. दिस इज द वेरियस हैबिटेट्स ऑफ प्लांट्स. नाउ सी हियर डेजर्ट एरिया कैक्टस एंड दिस प्लांट इज ऑन अ लैंड. मीन्स प्लांट्स हियर प्लांट्स आर क्लासिफाइड ऑन वेयर द दे आर ग्रो.